London.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. The Good Life TV welcomes you to this great episode. We'll be looking at one of the exclusive luxurious homes in Lagos. It is privately owned and not listed for sale, so I won't be disclosing the identity of the owner. However, the objective of the video is to appreciate the great taste in architecture and interior design. So I'll be doing a voiceover to guide you through the video. Oh yes, that's the least I can do. You know, Banana Island is just one of the most sophisticated islands in Lagos, you know. The boast of the creme de la creme, people of means and caliber. Very good, serene estate. And it's often suggested that the value of land go for as much as, you know, millions of naira, if not close to a billion. You know, so it's not surprising that people who get to build there build very luxurious, magnificent houses. So take it all with me while we explore. So yeah, if you can see, this is the main lounge. And one thing you should know about the owner is that he wanted something very unique. You know, he went for the white theme, and he was able to get an interior specialist that could deliver exactly what he wanted. Zen Decor, an interior deco company, was chosen as the preferred interior deco company to coordinate the interior furnishing of this home. This is no doubt a smart home, where all utilities are synchronized, from the curtains, to the lights, to the sound, everything. Quite a massive project, spanning well over 7 floors. 2 expansive swimming pools, a rooftop garden, a wine cellar, a gym, and luxurious kitchenette and bar at every corner you can think of. This is truly an epitome of luxury. Yeah, the house boasts of very good views, especially of the Koiling Bridge, a popular iconic landmark in Lagos. And it gives you a 360 view of the coastline. And if you look closely, you also see that it has a rooftop swimming pool, almost can be compared to our leaping size, you know, judging from the area, length and width. and it has a see-through floor glass panels that allows light diffuse into the living room beneath. At this stage, you know, a lot of cleaning and arrangements being made, and you can see that items are still being brought in. That's the gym. The house has a lift. It has two lifts to service the seven floors and a basement. And it has almost like a bar in every space you can think of. Like this one in particular happens to be very close to the cinema. You know, the cinema, sound insulated, can fit a capacity of about 40 people. And it has a central cooling system and sound system, everything concealed. Then it has a drop down screen. The screen comes down whenever you need it. And when not in use, it offers you a great view of the coastline. Wonderful. This is the height and depth of luxury. The refitting, the retrofitting company did a wonderful job. And Zen Decor, who for the most part coordinated all the teams, has proven yet again why she's the king of this sector. We have to give it to her. Every area you look at, you can see pieces of art displayed on the wall. And even the furniture looks very artistic. Like, if you look at this kitchenette area close to where the cinema is, you can see it's almost like a game room. So this is most likely designed to host friends when they come around. You know, they can have a bit of drinks, they can have a bit of food, they can play a bit of snooker, you know, and they can do some movies. And don't forget, on that same floor, you have another rooftop swimming pool that is accessible to those who come use the cinema. So this is like a party house, you know, a house that never gets any dull moment. Guests are always welcome there. It has a lot of space to accommodate as much guests as possible. And you can clearly see that the furnitures are white, both indoors and outdoor, which complements the theme of the building. You can see the building is a white building all around. You know, so the honest truth is I've never quite seen people use white or true and make it interesting, but this is a good example of the use of plain white and, you know, the interplay of the elements bringing out such beauty. This is the wine cellar. You can see clearly, you know, this is bigger than most houses you would find. Yes, it can take so much bottles, close to 1 million bottles. And you know, and this is what a typical suit looks like. Each of the suits comes complete with a living room, a kitchen, you know, a walk-in closet, and a balcony. And it's all equipped with automated curtains. And the bathrooms too are state of the art, with ceiling to floor windows, very exquisite furnitures, and very smart TVs. The idea was to have, you know, a very comfortable, adequate space to host dignitaries. So if perhaps the president was to come around with his cook and with some of his aides, they can all be in a suit without having to stay apart, you know. And this enables his guests to cook their own meals if they choose to. This is just mind-boggling.
Then I made a mess of my mind. body talk to me nice. Say now my love you didn't need for your life. Yeah, our love no be lie. Say yeah, we did together, yeah, day and night. Yeah, if I leave, you go by. Yeah, if you leave, I go
stroking by. Your back, baby. Loving your body, baby. As you're whining your body, baby. So crazy. Loving your body, baby. Girl, you want it to me.
The take really is the attention being paid to details. The attention to details is 100. You know, you can clearly see the finishing in the doors, you know, in the walls, paneling, you know, and even the fittings, you know, sanitary wares and the rainhead shower. I can see that most of these, you know, these fittings are concealed, you know. You know, very neat cotton, you know, even in the laying of the tiles. You know, the faucets, for example, you can see how well laid they are. You can see how the glass, for example, on this kitchen window looks. You know, everything, attention to detail. The, you know, the vendors really took their time to get it right. You know, they did a wonderful job. The building has a central core where the lifts and the staircases accesses all space on each floor. The central core becomes the center, you know, with all the spaces designed around it. This is actually the main floor, you know, so guests are ushered in, you know, by use of the lift from the ground floor. On the ground floor, though not particularly covered, we have, you know, on the ground floor, we have like an art gallery that welcomes you into the building. One wonderful design. So this is the other swimming pool. And taking the staircase up takes you to the rooftop garden. So we're finally approaching the higher levels of the building. And what the man simply did, the owner, was he wanted a green space, but one that could be private and one that could, you know, be well maintained away from prying eyes. And you know, men like this would always put security as a big consideration. And the only way these days is to have, you know, a space like this that you can always retire to. Without the fear of, you know, its security. So this is another party space, a rooftop garden, and it gathers glass panes that you can see through to the floor beneath, just like what we saw at the other floor. And it gives you a panoramic view of the whole of the Banana Island and the other coastal areas. You know, the building prides itself as one of the tallest on this side, so it's no surprising that, you know, it gets to enjoy the view. So this is the higher level where obviously you probably would have like the VIP session of the outdoor, and then, you know, just breathtaking, wonderful view. Wonderful view. Wonderful view. There's absolutely nothing like this ever. You know, people will often say that there's one thing to have money, then there's another thing to have good taste. And I think this house rightly combines both of them. Money and great taste. It is able to deliver on the brief. You know, the houses like this can best be compared to what you find in Los Angeles and the best places in the US. And it tells that the man is well traveled and he wants to enjoy whatever is available out there in his own home country, which he has simply done. These are real life plants, greenery. It was done by a landscape vendor, and as you can see, cubic volumes of sand was carried up. It was carefully laid, and this is a typical example of a green roof, you know, and it often requires great engineering because of the enormous weight this suspended slab would have to carry. So taking the staircase down brings us to the Olympic size swimming pool, which is the second out of two. And it's another party space, but it opens up into the gym and into a dynamic indoor space. Lovely. If you have enjoyed the tour of this house, please endeavor to subscribe to our channel and click on the like button. And you may also share with friends. You know, that would encourage us to bring more content like this to you. Thank you. And have an amazing time viewing.